not horrible.
It's better than the other one.
Dude, I'm telling you, we're miles ahead where we were on the other one.
Still has a floor.
Yeah. You know, a couple of small rust spots in the hidden areas, but compared to the other ones, pretty solid.
Yeah, I'm not hating
it. Firewall looks really good on this car, unlike the other one. We don't have any rust around the windshield trim.
No, it looks good.
Much better this time. Much better car.
All right, cool. Now y'all got a week to finish it.
Whole week?
7 days, get it done. I got to meet Dennis to see a man about a VW van.
Okay.
Quarters are still kind of... Are we replacing these, or what do you want to do?
No, we just don't have time. Here's the plan. You and Jeremy are going to tackle the wheel tubs. Do all the prep work we can before it goes to you. Put your suspension on so you can set your doors where they're going to be in your fenders. I know it's going to take a little more time, but that's the best way you're going to have to block the car.
I think with a convertible, that's a good idea. Yeah. Do we decide once we have all the weight in it to put subframe connectors or no?
I think we do.
I think we should.
Just simply because of the power this motor has now. The Butler is a 600 horsepower motor. It's going to have at least 550 at the rear. Applying all that horsepower is going to make the car want to twist and flex, especially on a convertible. So we're going to add subframe connectors to connect the subframe to the unibody to stiffen it up and make it handle way better.
It's too bad we got a badass Butler motor for a silly convertible car.
Top goes down, press goes up.
Exactly. That's what he's hoping for because he's going to need
That's what he always
wants. Let's get this thing started.
Cool. We have a really nice car here. It's not all rusty like our previous car. The problem is someone did poor workmanship. The way the quarters got put on, I don't think they really knew what they were doing. But when we put a big motor into this car, the car wants to twist and get a little bit more crazy. And these weak-ass welds, things are going to start breaking. The more I looked at it, the overlapping of rusty parts over holes and whatnot, it was just the best idea to take them off. It's a little risky to cut off the quarter panels before the new ones get here, but we're behind. And any time spent waiting is just time wasted.
Hi. I got some good news for you.
Need to get these quarter panels in so we can get them welded on and out the door.
Hope they fit.
Side looks good. Does that in fit too?
I don't know about his side, but my side looked great.
Yeah, yours is like done.
I see to fit a deck lid and a door.
I thought we were going for lightning. Lighten the car up.
Swiss cheese.
And you win.
I won.
This quarter panel is less dense.
Next, fit some doors, or a door and a deck lid. Make sure that this thing's back far enough, forward far enough, wherever it needs to be. The deck lid and the door will tell us.
Do we need that wrench?
Maybe. I don't have a striker in there or anything, so it's kind of a dry run.
Oh, well.
I'm just more or less concerned with length, I think.
Yeah. It's on suspension, so it's going to
come
change.
Down with it. I just want to make sure that, like, there's not an inch gap or something.
Yeah. Dang.
Yeah.
That's good.
That ain't going to work. I can adjust the door. Hold on.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. See, this is why we check it. Make sure we don't have a gap like that. Like, Evel Knievel wouldn't jump that gap.
You know how valuable it is when they wrap it like this.
Look at that.
Woo!
Dyno's at 550 horse on pump gas. Pull the carb off, put an engine hoist on it, and drop it in.
Since the 467 motor came ready to install, we can fit it straight into the subframe and be ready for the headers and transmission. The subframe and everything attached to it will be one giant time-saving pre-built unit.
Watch your jack stand.
Right above it.
You look like you're centered on that mount.
Yes, sir.
That's it.
We're gonna fit these headers right now. If they're all clear, then we're gonna get the transmission out and bolted in.
The trick with these headers is squeezing them in with a massive motor. And when you up the horsepower, you usually lose a bunch of room in the engine bay.
It's your Firebird headers, right?
Mm-hmm.
More power and more engine. They need to fit because there's no plan B.
Right here, it's super tight, but it's not smashed into it. It's just tight. Okay, how's about that transmission?
Since our car was an automatic originally, they gave us everything to convert this to the 5-speed manual that we have now.
You want to stab it right now?
I'm with it.
Got it?
Yep, okay. It's there.
There you go.
Nailed it.
A transmission is always finicky at install because the input shaft is dry as a bone, but that's just how it goes. Anyway, the last items to go on the subframe are the core support and the radiator.
And these things keep everything super cool with a motor that size in Texas?
Yeah, that's the big thing. And we're gonna have AC,
yep.
All that.
So we're gonna be pushing the limits of temperature on this thing.
Once we get the radiator installed, we'll basically have over 20% of the car built just right here on the subframe. The next step will be to attach it to the unibody.
Wow. Smooth as silk. Such a cool setup.
I'll get a few coats of blue laid down and then an extra generous coat of clear before the car gets some dry time overnight. Well,
it's blue,
and I got a lot of trash in this one.
But we're
gonna buff it. I put an extra coat of clear on it. Just
don't wink at me.
Don't wink at
me. Feel so uncomfortable when you do that.
Fine, I won't. Why don't you like my winks?
I don't. It makes me feel uncomfortable.
They're like manly bro winks.
No,
like
it makes me feel
fives.
Like you're trying to flirt with me, and I don't
I'm
like
not
it.
Flirting with you.
I know,
they're
but
like
that's
bro
how
fives.
I feel.
Richard's deadline for the car is coming up fast. There's no time for a redo on this one, but he approved it, so I'm sure he'll like it.
Is it done yet?
We just painted it yesterday. I like the color a lot.
Yeah? Yeah.
I got some trash in it, but I put a lot of coats of stuff on it.
There is some trash in it.
Is this called orange peeling?
So all that'll go away. So all the texture and the trash when we color sand and buff it will go away.
The term orange peel comes from, you guessed it, an orange. If you ever look at an orange, it has texture to it, has little imperfections. What we do is we go back, we sand it smooth, we polish all those sand marks out, and voila, you get a finished product that looks nice and flat and shiny.
I don't know, man. It is like blue. I don't know if I'm a fan or not, to tell you the truth.
It's one of those things I think once it's all together, you're gonna love it.
It's your windshield post, so you can see the chrome against this blue.
And then the wheels are gonna have a big chrome lip.
Yeah.
I think it'll look really good with the chrome and stuff.
It's blue though.
That's Richard in a nutshell. That's what I deal with.
I don't seem excited out there, audience. It's because I don't like blue.
I like blue.
Still has on his morning hair.
You guys killed it.
Hey Jason.
Yeah.
Did he like it?
He winked back, see?
I told you he winked.
Y'all are like,
stop winking, yeah. Stop with the winking.
The blue's great. The wheels will make the car look like the Super Resto Mod it was meant to be. And just in time, because here comes you-know-who.
All right, somebody tell me something about something, because this should be on the ground running.
Yeah, we're pushing down here.
We're trying.
Actually, the car, once it has exhaust, is ready to fire up.
Okay.
I feel really good about it.
I'm not going to feel good about it until it's on the ground. Actually, I'm not going to feel good about it until it's sold. Because, you know, somebody talked me into painting it blue, and I hate blue.
It's a great color.
Just get it done, guys. I might have a buyer.
Is he gone yet?
It's down to the final push. John's getting the wiring dialed in. We've got the new top on, and our buddy Emilio is here with our seats.
Hey, look who I found wandering around outside.
The new ultra leather interior is the right choice for a convertible. This is the same stuff they use in private jets. Comfortable, but durable.
Done and done.
All that's left now is to fuel this baby up and see if she fires.
There you go.
I get nervous every time we go to start a car. It doesn't matter if it's a brand new motor or rebuilt motor.
Are we ready to go?
Remember, you got a manual, but yes, moment of truth. Make it happen.
Sounds like battery's a little weak.
Yeah, that battery's way weak.
Pump it.
The first time's always, there's so many things that can go wrong.
Once it warmed up, that thing was purring like a kitten.
Oh, that thing sounded amazing. And as soon as I was able to give it some gas.
No?
What do you think, Tony?
I think it sounds like it's faster than it is.
Dude, we can't ask for more than that.
That's great.
That's awesome. Tony's excited, I can tell. That's his excited face.